And can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, under the PTC, today we shall see about the aseptic conditions and sterilization. This is an important topic. So, what do you mean by aseptic condition and why one should do? This is because we are growing our plants in vitro and we are providing all the conditions, the environmental condition, what is available outside to our plant. Simultaneously, we are providing it with media, which consists of nutrients. So usually what happens is the microorganisms, okay, they also try to invade the media and start proliferating in it. So that is why we have to see that there is aseptic or completely sterile condition available. Otherwise, it will be contaminated by your microorganism. And one more point is, always when there is contamination by microorganism, we know that the microorganism generation time is very fast. So they outgrow the plant. That is, they can grow faster than the plants and they can suppress the growth of the plant, resulting in their death. So that this is the reason why we should follow the sterile condition or aseptic techniques. And also you know that the environment, okay, which consists of the air, is fully highly contaminated. For example, you can see that sneezing itself can produce 100,000 to 200,000 droplets of microorganism. So you can just imagine how much contamination it is causing to the environment, the air. So these contaminated particles, okay, from whatever the people are sneezing or coughing, whatever, it consists of many microorganisms. And apart from microorganisms, it consists of even the spores. So it is very difficult to eliminate the spores. And the frequent contamination what we see in the PTC is the bacterial contamination. So usually what we do is, whenever we are using our explant, okay, explant, as I told you, it is a small piece of plant, whether it is leaf, bud or ovary or anther, anything, okay, it is a part of the plant, is called as an explant. So we are using the explant to develop it into a fully grown plant, which means that is the meaning of totipotency. So they are usually introduced with the explant, who, that is the microorganisms. So whenever you are taking the explant to grow it in the laboratory, you are sometimes adding even in your microorganisms. This is because always the explant, whatever we take, no, it is always surface sterilization we do. Only the surfaces of the explants are sterilized. But what about the interior of the tissue? If the microorganism is present in the interior of the tissue, and when you start developing that explant, automatically it gets contaminated because the microorganism was hidden within. Okay, you have just done the surface sterilization, but the hidden microorganism within the interior tissue escapes the sterilization. So this can lead to contamination. Also, so to avoid contamination, last class itself we told that we are going to use laminar airflow. See, this laminar airflow also can get contaminated. So what we have to do is, whenever you are placing laminar hood, okay, that is the lath, whenever you are placing the lath, you should see that the lath is not directly towards the door, okay, because the doors you will be simply opening. So what if you place, if this is a door and if you are placing the laminar hood here and frequently the door is kept open, lath will get contaminated. Otherwise, if there is no option at all, then you have to keep a double door. So here the people can walk about. You can just open this door and then open this door. Then you have the lab. So also the individuals who are using, who are doing this plant culture, even they should take lot of precautions. Okay, like they should wear sterilized cloth or headgear. And before entering into the sterilization area, they have to see that they have swabbed their hands with alcohol. And also some other, like, you are not supposed to talk, not supposed to sneeze. So these all precautions you should take. So cleanliness and proper care of equipment are vital operations of the tissue culture laboratory. So besides this contamination, you should see that all your equipment, whatever you are operating, even they are under the sterile conditions. So usually what a tissue culture individual, I told you, he himself should be sterilized, wear all sterilized clothing, and also he should see that he sterilizes the hand frequently. I told you that using at least 75% of alcohol. So whenever we are sterilizing, you can see that if the spores are present, these spores can survive the sterilization condition, which can further lead to the contamination of the tissues. So usually whenever there is a bacterial growth, it is easy to see through your naked eye because it gives a characteristic appearance, okay, like ooze-like appearance, or they'll be having different colors, this bacteria. So like cream color, pink color, which you can see in your fruits and vegetables when they are getting contaminated, okay, and they'll be having off odor, that is the smell. And whenever your tissue culture is contaminated with fungi, okay, you can see a fussy growth, because fussy growth and different appearance of the color, because always you see that fungi have the hypha or the mycelium growth, you can see. So what the scientists are doing is, we have a separate chapter on meristem culture. They go for meristem culture because the apex of the shoot, okay, if this is a plant and the apex of the shoot is always free from contamination, even from the virus, it is free of contamination. So they take this part of the plant for tissue culture. So what are the sources of contamination? Means we already told that there is a lot of microorganism, because the microorganisms also use the nutrients of the plant, and which results in the death of the plant. They exhaust the nutrient, that is, they consume all the nutrients without giving anything left over for the plant or your explant to grow. And another important point is, the microorganism change the secondary metabolites. So whenever I'm doing plant culture, sometimes we also use the metabolic product, secondary metabolic product of the plant. These metabolic products can be either your citric acid or certain medicinal component of the plant, amino acid, the resins, the gum. These are all secondary metabolites which are produced by the plant, and it is highly economical. Okay, it is highly useful for man. That is why we grow these plants in the tissue culture, so that we can propagate this plant, multiply the plant, and we can get the secondary metabolites. But what this microorganism will do is, whenever it is contaminating your media, it has all chances to change the secondary metabolite and make it worthless. We can't use it. Okay. So apart from microorganisms, we have other contamination also. As already spoken, the explant itself is contaminated. Though you do the surface sterilization, the microorganism may be hidden somewhere within the interior of the tissue, which you are not able to eradicate. the vessels which we use, vessels means the culture vessels which we are using. It may be a bottle, a white mouth flask or bottles, whatever we use, that may be contaminated. The media, what we are preparing, we wouldn't have taken proper precautions to prepare the media and sterilize the media. So that can lead to contamination. The instruments, what we are using, particularly we are going on using the autoclave, oven, pH meters to see what is the pH value of the media. So when these instruments itself are contaminated, it again adds to the source of contaminating. And finally, the environment where handling is taking place, that is your transfer room or media preparation room. Okay. So that entire environment itself is contaminated. It is not sterilized, and the individual is not also is not taking any precautions to keep himself sterilized. It leads to a source of contamination. That is why aseptic condition is absolute necessary for the tissue culture to maintain a sterile condition so that we can proceed with our experiment to get the perfect output. So when we're telling aseptic techniques, the aseptic techniques can be your chemical treatment or physical treatment. Under chemical treatment, you can see various disinfectants, antibiotics, or here in physical treatment, we can see about the sterilization with autoclave, hot air oven, or even radiation and filtration. So these are some of the methods wherein we use in the tissue culture laboratory to see that there is no contamination or any dust particles present. So coming to the disinfectant. So whenever I'm using disinfectant, how this disinfectant is bringing about inactivation of the bacteria? How it is killing my bacteria? That is, your disinfectants can penetrate into the bacteria and then it can denature the bacterial protein, or it can decrease the enzyme activity. They inhibit the bacterial metabolism. So when the metabolism is occurring in steps, it can inhibit this metabolic pathway. So the end product is not produced and your bacteria can ultimately die. So they can damage the structure of the cell membrane. Okay, you have this, these bacteria will be having their cell membranes. It can make hole through this membranes, and then whatever the materials are present in the bacteria can ooze out of it, killing the bacteria. Okay, that is what they change the membrane permeability. So these are the ways in which disinfectants can kill the bacteria. Coming to the next part, that is here we are going to see that how we can sterilize a plant material, that is the explant what I am taking. Suppose say this is a plant, okay, this is a plant of my interest, for example I'm saying, and then I know that this plant is carrying some desirable trait which is of interest to me, which is economically important and beneficial for mankind. So what will I do is, suppose I take this part of the leaf and that leaf will become your explant. Okay, this is your explant. Now what I have to do, I have to sterilize it. So how we are going to sterilize it? Plant material should only be surface sterilized at suitable concentration. This becomes very important. See, to obtain sterile plant material is difficult because in the process of sterilizing, the living material should not lose their biological activity. When you're sterilizing, your aim is to discard the microorganism and it should not affect the sterilant, whatever you're using chemical, it should not harm your plant. If it harms your plant, the biological activity of your plant is lost. So the plant organs or tissue are therefore only surface sterilized by treatment with disinfectant solution at suitable concentration for a specified period. So you should be careful of what is the concentration I'm using, what is the time limit I'm using it. Otherwise, apart from killing the microorganism, you're destroying your biological activity of your plant of interest. So what are the disinfectant we can use? Is chemical disinfectant. I can use 10 to 12% of hydrogen peroxide for 5 to 15 minutes, bromine water 1 to 2% for 2 to 10 minutes, 1% solution of chlorine water with mercury and silver nitrate can be used, and absolute alcohol is also used for only hard tissues, that is seeds, your root, which can withstand the alcohol. Okay, the pure absolute alcohol which can withstand, only they can be used. Otherwise, if you are going to use delicate tissues, no, like this flower or buds and all, if you're going to put it in the absolute alcohol, it is going to dehydrate the those tissues also. So you should be careful what explant I am using, what chemical is suitable for that plant, how much minutes I should immerse my plant into that particular disinfectant. And also look at this bromine water. The bromine, actually what we get is highly concentrated and we dilute it with water. Okay, that is known as bromine water. And mercury, chloride, silver nitrate, these are all what somewhat toxic, poisonous. So when you are using this, you should take utmost care that this does not enter into your skin and result in poisoning of you. That is the important precautions we have to take. But most of the time in tissue culture, we use this. Okay, like sodium hypochlorite. For 5 to 30 minutes, I can use sodium hypochlorite, or calcium hypochlorite, we can use again this for 5 to 30 minutes. Okay, most commonly which are used. So your sodium hypochlorite, you can use it at a concentration of 2%, whereas your calcium hypochlorite, you can use at a concentration of 9 to 10%, or 70% ethanol is used for disinfecting plant tissues, which are delicate tissue. There we told about absolute alcohol. Here it is only 70% alcohol, which can be used for delicate tissue treatment. And usually it is used for only few seconds, and also for disinfecting the hands of the users. Okay, there you can see that we'll be using 70% ethanol, or even isopropanol is recommended for rubbing the alcohol. Now sometimes what happens is the microorganisms, okay, the entire plant will be having lot of contamination from the microorganisms. Okay, this is known as systemic contamination. That is, the entire plant itself is getting contaminated. During that time, what you can do is you can wash it with all these chemicals. Okay, after that you can rinse them with antibiotics. Okay, the antibiotics becomes important if the plant is having systemic infection. But remember, after treating your plant materials with the following disinfectants, final rinse, okay, should always be given with the distilled water. So this point you have to remember. Whether whatever disinfectants, antibiotics I am going to use for my plant, after that particular minute, you have to wash it with your distilled water. That becomes an absolute importance for the plant, not for the worker. So we can see here the hard explants like root, seed, mature endosperms are directly treated with disinfectant because they can withstand it. Now, sometimes what happens, an explant carries a heavy load of microorganisms. So these such type of plants needs to be washed in running tap water for 1 to 2 hours prior to its treatment with the disinfectant of the plant. So if it is carrying a heavy load of microorganism, for 10 to 2 hours, you have to wash it with running water before you are or prior to the use of the disinfectant. This becomes an at most important. And also some of the plants, like you see the shoot apex or the pollen grains, okay, they are free from microbial contamination. Thereby, for such type of plant materials, it is not necessary you do the surface sterilization. It is not compulsory. Otherwise, you can use even detergents. Certain detergents are available, or these are surfactants, okay, like Triton X, Twin 80. Okay, these are used for treating the plant material. See, what are, I told you, the antibiotics what we are going to use. It can be carbamazepine, tetracycline, streptomycin, rifampicin. All these antibiotics can be used for the treatment of the plant if it is necessary. But when you're using antibiotics, even that comes with some demerits. Problem with antibiotics is they tend to be selective. Okay, selective in the sense an antibiotic cannot kill all the bacteria. It can kill only the specific bacteria. Only the specific one it can kill. Resistance to acquisition. That is, what happens is certain microorganisms, like we know, like many of the microorganisms, like our body has become resistant to the antibiotics. Though you take, you see that we end up again in the disease conditions because the microorganism is becoming resistant to those antibiotics. So that becomes a big question. What if it becomes resistant, the microorganisms? We can't use that. And also, like they may obscure the presence of microorganisms. That is, it is very, sometimes it becomes very unclear or uncertain for the antibiotic itself to know that whether there is a presence of microbes or not. Because these will be hidden. The microbe can be hidden somewhere within the plant. So also some of the antibiotics can inhibit the cell and tissue growth, because we are growing the cells, we are growing the tissue, we are growing the organs in vitro condition. And suppose if I'm adding antibiotics into this, this antibiotic can interfere with my explant which I am growing. So these are some of the demerits when we are using the antibiotics. So we have to look which antibiotics is suitable. Coming to UV radiations, as already we have spoken about it, UV radiations, which is present in, it is a germicidal, it is present in the laminar, hair, hood, or your lab, or your cabinet, or even the room, you can fix it. Okay. So these are non-ionizing radiation, which is having a very high wavelength of nanometer, of 200 to 400 nanometer, but the most preferable is 254 nanometer, but you have to take the precautions that you are not present when the UV radiation is on, because it leads to mutations. Now, next, coming to the heating. The heating can be of two types, okay, dry heat and the wet heat. When we are saying dry heat, it is preferably your micro oven. Okay, all the glass vases used in the PTC should and must be sterilized before use. And your solution, your culture vessels are usually autoclaved. They are not treated with dry heat. Who? Your solution, whatever the media you're making, and the culture vessels into which you're pouring your media, they are all autoclaved. And also the temperature sensitive compounds, okay, like your growth hormones, the plant growth hormones, okay, they all cannot be sterilized, or they cannot be treated with dry oven, a dry heat. So what you have to do is, because they are very unstable, they're heat labile compounds. So what you can do is you can filter sterilize such type of compound, which compounds growth hormones. Okay, you should do a filter sterilization. I'll show you this in the next slide. So you have to take precautions. The containers, the containers means the culture vessels in which the explants are cultured are called as culture vessels. It can be your culture vessels can be your test tubes, okay, or it can be your bottles, or it can be any flask, okay. So whenever you are using these type of culture vessels, you have to see that there is a properly fit tight lid. Or sometimes what happens is some of the culture vessels are fitted with membrane filters, okay, they'll be having membrane filters through which exchange air can exchange. So whenever you're starting with plant tissue culture, you have to see that your glass vases are clean, and which glass vase should go into dry heat and which should go for a wet heat should be decided. And if they are heat labile compounds, then they should be filter sterilized. So a micro oven, why we are using is for the melting of the agar, so that you require a special container when you are using the micro oven. Flaming or heating, that is your incinerating, your scalpel, your needles or your loops, all this you are going for flaming, that is 95% ethanol in an alcohol burner. This is an instrument is useful for sterilizing the metal instrument. So all your metal instrument goes for flaming. See in the next picture, this is what alcohol will be there, and then it can incinerate all this equipments there. Coming to autoclaving, okay, in autoclave I told you that it's generating, autoclaves generate steam. So it is steam heat under pressure, a very good method even for killing of the spores. So here you use, the condition is 121 degree centigrade for 15 pounds per inch. So under this condition, it can bring about perfect sterilization. It is very fast and it is effective. And also one problem is when you're using solution like water or medium for your PTC, the time of autoclaving is very important. You can see here, if I'm having 250 ml of solution, I should autoclave it for only 15 minutes, 500 means 30 minutes, 1000 ml means 40 minutes. So has my solution concentration, the volume, not concentration, as my volume of the solution increases, you can see that the time period also increases for the autoclaving. Excessive autoclaving is not advisable because it leads to the breakdown of your organic compounds. Your organic compounds can become charred, okay? So even if there is sucrose or is present, it becomes caramelized. So what happens, that nutrient will not be suitable for the growth of the microorganisms. Coming to the filtration, you can see that, as I told you, these growth promoting hormones like the gibberellic acid or indoleacetic acids, the proteins or antibiotics are only filtered. They cannot go for dry heat or wet heat. And usually here what happens, one simple example I have shown here, see, you can put all your liquid, the solutions, whatever told, into the syringe, and that to that syringe a filter is fixed. Okay, if it is usually a cellulose membrane, okay, here it will be fixed, and when you press your the syringe, all the fluid will come and get collected in the tube. So what is happening if there is any contamination in this non-sterile liquid, it will be filtered out of the by using this membrane, and you'll get a sterile fill liquid or the media, whatever is necessary. So this is really one of the very good method. This is a simple membrane filter I have shown, which can accommodate very little amount of fluid. When you're going for large amount of solution, then you can go for vacuum filtration. So with this, we can end our today's section.